Welcome you students in the last session of the chapter sexual reproduction in the flowering plant. Today we going to start the post fertilization event. It consists of the development of the endosperm, development of the embryo, maturation of the ovule into the seed and maturation of the ovary into the fruit, right? So let's we start the development of the endosperm. As I told you earlier that one N that with the male gamete can be fused with the 2N number of the polar nuclei in the embryo sac, okay, to form the endosperm, right? So endosperm is formed here. So endosperm start to develop, proceed the embryo development. Whenever the embryo is going to start, in the same time endosperm is also show their developing stages, okay, but it is rich in the food materials. That means they have reserved the food material for the developing embryo. So according to the division, endosperm are the three types. First is the nuclear mean here the dead cell is divide mitotically without cytokinesis, and the endosperm is the free nuclear like that one. Cell can be divide mitotically one by one, that's when the nuclear cell is formed. Whenever after that one, the cell wall is laid down in between them. Here the cell wall is formed. So that structure is look like that one. Okay. If endosperm is completely utilized by the embryo in the third one, if endosperm is completely utilized, that means cell will be the halobial. Okay. Halobial mean if it should be the non-albuminous seed. Okay. If endosperm is fully used, like in the pea or the bean. Bean are there, okay. In the albuminous seed, what happen if endosperm is persist, like in the coconut, that is a watery substance is there, no? You know very well. Yes, these are the things. Okay, so what is embryo? I told you in the last session that a male gamete is fused with the female gamete, 1N, 1N number, to form the zygote, 2N number. So that is a zygote is formed. So in the case of the zygote, what happen? Zygote is further divided into the two cells. Upper one is the terminal cell and lower is the basal cell. Basal cell is further divided. Okay, it is further divided while the same terminal cell is also divided to form the two cell stage. That is the two cell stage. After that, two cell divided into the four cell stage. While in the liver, in the lower one is there suspensor to increase the number of cell up to the 6, 7, 8 number of cells are there in the single row, right? The all things are named as the suspensor, while the upper one tetraid is there embryo. That tetraid is get the globular shape when the irregular division will be there. Globular change into the heart shape. That is a heart shape structure of embryo. When the here is the pressure to form the one layer, so that is the formation of the another type of embryo, that's named as the torpedo. Okay, which name is there? The torpedo stage is there. So just we going revise once more. In the dicot consist of the embryonic axis having the two cotyledon. First of all, in the cotyledon, the upper part, that is the upper part, is epicotyl. Just suppose that is the upper part is the epicotyl. Epicotyl can be modified into the plumule. Plumule can be formed the stem, while the lower portion is named as the hypocotyl, and hypocotyl to form the radicle. Okay, remember in the dicot case, clear? In the monocot, first scutellum is present towards the one side on the embryonic axis, okay, that's name is the scutellum, which is near scutellum. So that's the area of the scutellum, okay, on the lateral side. In the lateral side, what happen? In the lower side, radical cap is enclosed, undifferentiated seed name is the coleorrhiza, and the lower portion is name is the coleorrhiza. That portion is name is the coleorrhiza, while the upper portion is name is the epicotyl, which further form to the suit apex. Okay, so remember these point beta. After that one, what is seed or the fertilized ovule? That is the final product of the sexual reproduction. You know very well. Seed present inside the fruit? No, very well. But occasionally in the black pepper and the beet. Ruminant of the nucellus is also present. That's name as the perisperm. That name as the perisperm. That is a ruminant nucleus. Then it covered by the help of the integuments which form the protective seed coats. Integuments modified to the protective coat of the seed. And the micropylar, where then there will the one empty space is there in that structure, you know very well. At the micropylar end, there is the some vacant space is there where nuclear cell are not present. So that is the area where exchange of the oxygen or the water take place during the seed germination. Clear? Right. After that one, what do you mean by the seed dormancy? We study earlier that the pollen grains behave as the good fossil because due to presence of the hard covering. In the same manner, seeds is also become as the fossil due to the hard layer outside, because when the seed formation is going to start and at the end, then it should be said, okay, so what happened in that case? At presently, then there will be the water contents in the lot of amount of the water contents will be present in the seed. Whenever with the passing of time, water should be lost out. Unfavorable environment will be there, so it's become as the dry. If water contents is not there, so it is not easily decomposed by the microorganisms. Enzymes are inactive form. Enzymes are in the inactive form, but when they get the favorable environment, so they start to growing. Okay, so here the ovule change into the seed. Clear? The ovule change into the seed and ovary change into the fruit. So first study that one. Fleshy fruit. Fleshy, like our mango, orange, guava, that is the fleshy fruit will be present. In the dry fruit, like our mustard, that is hard in nature, groundnut. Okay, what is the true fruit? That is very important definition asked by the examiner. True, because fruit can be formed by the ovary. If fruit is formed from the ovary, that is true fruit. If it is formed by any other part, especially the thalamus, with any other part except the ovary, that is the false fruit. But in the parthenocarpic, again important term asked by the examiner, if fruit is developed without fertilization, but mostly it is only by the phytohormones, by the plant hormones, like in the banana. Okay, when a seed lose water contents and become dry, it become as the inactive. So it become active when it get good temperature, oxygen and the water molecule. Clear? So they are the other different type of reproduction are there under the heading the spatial reproduction. That name is the apomixis. That is the mimic form. That is a mimic form of the sexual reproduction. But in real manner, it is a asexual reproduction. In that case, the example will be the asteraceae and the grasses. Okay, here the zygote can be undergoing the reductional division to form the diploid egg cell, and diploid egg cell to form the embryo. Clear? In that case, if that one is. Then another is the polyembryony, when the number of embryo can be formed, but embryo can be formed only one, as you know, in the embryo sac. But here is the some difference will be there, like nucleus cells surround the embryo sac and start to divide, enter into the embryo sac, then it develops into the embryo. Okay, if more than one embryo is present, name as the polyembryo. You just study the orange, number of seeds are there, lemon, mango, onion, right, the groundnut, like these are the structures. Okay beta, so that is our chapter is over. if you have any doubt at last, so you drop the message on my WhatsApp number 9671200638 for any query in the biology. Okay, you just type the one question, what term you need to ask. So you will also mail me on my mail ID is anilkumar@gmail.com. Thank you very much for watching video. Thank you.